And this has been fighting you, and you have been struggling with this. It goes, it comes, please come out.
That was a message of prophecy, that there is a brother in the midst of the congregation, that contrary spirit entered into him, and the man should come out for deliverance. What the screen of a television sets?
I'm the one with evil spirit will enter and attack and go and come back. I came from United States because of that. Mm-hmm. To this church, to be delivered.
Tell me how you came about this.
I moved to a house, I bought a new house, and I moved into that place, and from there, the evil spirit started attacking that evil spirit in that house, and I prayed, I do all what I could. The spirit would continue to attack and attack and attack, come in and go, come in and go.
You have to open up so that you get free, okay?
Yes.
The Lord sent me to you.
Man of God, I remember everything now. He was trying to give me power, and I said, I don't want no black power. That's the devil. So they've been following me, attacking me since then.
And they speak to you?
Yes.
What are you doing for a living?
I'm a clinical nurse. I work with the military. My name is Taiwo. The prophecy I received today was really true, that the devil will enter me in an attack, and it's really true.
There is a brother there. I see contrary spirit enter you, and this has been fighting you, and you have been struggling with this. It goes, it comes, please come out.
And I'm glad that the prophet was able to say it today.
So how does this prophecy relate to your life? Can you tell us some of the things, experiences you have been having before now that God Almighty actually revealed the root cause of your problem?
Really, really terrible. We moved to a house. We thought it's going to be okay. But it was this devil would... It was living there, and because we started praying, he started attacking, wanted to give me power to use, and I denied it. I didn't want anything to do with the dark. But since then, it's been a terrible thing, attacking my family and giving me a horrible life.
But today that God Almighty was able to reveal the root cause of your problem, how do you feel?
I feel so much. I feel so great.
Your mom. She's sick.
Yes, she's sick.
You cannot afford to lose her at this time. The woman suffer. They call her all sort of names.
Yes.
They call her wish.
Yes.
There is no name they have not called this woman.
Yes.
I'm here standing to tell you that this woman is not a wish. I know in Zambia they are watching Imane TV. Please, the whole country, I want you to listen. This woman is not a witch. She's innocent. And they have offended the spirit of God. The woman wants to die because they have labored her.
Yes, please.
Because of this, she really wants to die.
Yes.
And leave this world. Because of the name you people call this woman, that is the cause of the problem the family is having today.
Yes.
No please. Single person have a settled marriage.
Yes, please. I come from a polygamy family, so it has brought a lot of confusion. My mother has been called a witch, and that has brought her down. Even now she's sick, and even when I was coming here, she told me that I should remember her in my prayers, as I'll be on my prayer line.
I am Grace Mwanza from Zambia. The prophecy that the man of God told me was that my mother is sick and she has been called to be a witch.
Where is your mom?
She's home in Zambia.
She's sick.
Yes, she's sick.
You cannot afford to lose her at this time. The woman suffer. They call her all sort of names.
Yes.
They call her witch.
Yes.
There is no name they have not called this woman.
Yes. So he said that all those people that have called a witch, they've not prospered in their life.
Because of the name you people call this woman, That is the cause of the problem the family is having today.
Yes.
No single person have a settled marriage.
Yes. It is true, I come from a polygamy family. Since my father died in 1993, there's been problems.
So with the prophetic message that the man of God gave concerning your mom, how do you see your mom now?
The problem has been solved because the prophetic message has come out, and I believe that when something comes up, which means there's a solution.
Early one Sunday morning, we can see a car parked outside the synagogue, Church of All Nations. Inside the car is a man who cannot walk due to a fracture of the tibia and fibula bones of his right leg.
With a vacant expression on his face, Mr. Patrick Francis holds the placard displaying his problem. Attached to the placard is a medical report, which states the cause of the fractures was a fast-moving motorbike which hit Mr. Francis on his way to work.
This is the area where Mr. Francis's bones are fractured. You can see from the dry condition of his foot that he has not been able to use his leg at all since the accident.
The X-ray shows the degree of internal damage Mr. Francis's legs have sustained. The red arrow points to where the two bones are fractured.
Let's hear from him.
My name is Mr. Patrick Francis. My age is 36 years. I cannot walk due to fracture of the tibia and fibula.
All right, can you tell us, ever since you have this problem, what are the things you cannot do by yourself?
The thing that I cannot do by myself, virtually everything, sir. I cannot do anything on my own.
Who has been the one assisting you to the toilet, to the bathroom, and to do whatever you wish to do?
My wife.
All right. Ever since you've been in this condition, how do you feel as a man?
It has been a problem because due to, as a man, tying me down, this is my first time of me being down like this. It affects my job and everything, which I cannot.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a pipe fitter. I work with construction company. I've been to hospital, changing from one hospital to other. I see no solution because there is a cut that is bringing out pus, and of which I believe is only divine intervention that can solve it for me. The medical report I got is from the doctor, orthopedic doctor that have been treating me. I see that there is no improvement. I decided to come to Synagogue Church of All Nations.
All right, we can also see an X-ray report behind you. When you see other young men walking on their legs, how do you feel as a young man who's supposed to be on his feet by now?
I feel very, very bad because his inability to do things on my own is painful. She's the one who has been helping me all this while.
Let's hear from her. We believe she has one or two things to say concerning your condition.
My name is Elizabeth Patrick. We are living in Kaduna.
The gentleman sitting inside the vehicle, who is it to you?
He's my husband. He cannot do anything at all, especially toilet, bathroom. I do help him. Honestly, I'm not very happy because what a man can do, and he cannot do it again.
And what's your belief in God?
I believe in God that as he's here now, God will surely prove he's God.
I'll pray with you that the Lord Almighty will set your husband free today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said his name is Mr. Patrick Francis, and that since the motorbike accident, he has not been able to walk or do anything else without assistance. He has come here today believing that there is never a problem Jesus Christ cannot solve. Mr. Francis cultivates an atmosphere of belief as he awaits his encounter with Prophet T.B. Joshua.
Later that Sunday, Prophet T.B. Joshua is praying for the people at the Synagogue Church of All Nations prayer line. Jesus Christ still works wonders, miracles, and signs through suitable men.
Man of God, please help my husband. He cannot walk. Due to accident, sir. Please, sir. Man of God, please, he cannot walk. He cannot do anything on his own. We came all the way from Kaduna, sir.
man of God heads towards the vehicle where Mr. Francis is waiting.
Man of God, help me. I want to walk like others. I cannot walk. I cannot walk due to motorcycle accident. I cannot walk. Man of God, please help me. Please help me. Man of God, help me.
The man of God instructs Mr. Francis' wife to pray for her husband.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
As the spirit prayer is still going on, Mr. Francis' feet and toes begin to twitch in reaction to the power of the Holy Spirit as new life enters his body.
The man of God now touches the toes of Mr. Francis. He beckons Mr. Francis to move forward.
The prayer in the power of the Holy Spirit continues.
He falls under the anointing.
Never a problem Jesus Christ cannot solve, never a burden Jesus Christ cannot bear.
Glory be to God, Mr. Francis is now standing all on his own.
Expressions of pain cover his face as the fire of the Holy Spirit continues to perfect his healing. This is no ordinary pain he feels.
Mr. Francis cries out under the healing influence of the Holy Spirit as God completes his healing.
Watch the screen. You can see what is happening right there. See the expression of pain and agony on the face of this man. Spiritual operation. It's taking place right there.
With the tap of his fingers, the man of God, T.B. Joshua, declares Mr. Patrick Francis free.
See the man walking after the prayer of the anointed man of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
See him walking.
Thank you, Jesus.
My name is Fiona Song and I'm from London, England. And I was just amazed to see this man, a spiritual miracle that was going on. And there are no natural words to describe it. It is a spiritual miracle. And we just thank God. It is like seeing the book of Acts at work. And I feel so privileged to be here to watch this.
Hello, my name is Paul. I'm from South Africa. And wow, the mighty hand of God really works in it. Absolutely. The man was sitting in the car and suddenly, just a miracle, he just started to walk. And we thank God. He's an awesome God. We thank him. Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord.
My name is Brenda Sadiki. I'm 32 years of age. I'm coming from South Africa. I have experienced the presence of God in this place. God is meeting people's needs, healing people from their sickness, casting all the demons out in a very powerful way. People are getting healed. I used to see this happening in television. I'm very happy. I praise, I uplift the holy name because I am seeing it with my own eyes today.
Yes, seeing is believing. I may thank God Almighty for his goodness in the life of the people.
My name is Dr. Vincent Moser. I'm a medical doctor and I practice in Nassau, Bahamas. I've seen that the days of miracles are not over. And we thank Lord Jesus Christ for the miracle I saw when this man, Mr. Patrick Francis, who has fracture of the medial shaft of the fibula and tibia, these are the bones of the leg, it's impossible to walk with those fractures. But I was able to see today that this man walked after prayers for the man in the synagogue for the prophet T.B. Joshua. So praise and honor be to God. This is really a miracle. What I'm saying is when you look at the x-ray, you can see that it's quite obvious. You can see this is the tibia, and this is the fracture there, and this is the fuller, the smaller bone has fracture there. Normally to treat this, you have to put the patient in a cast, and because the bones are not aligned, at times they may need what they call internal fixation with pins. But this patient, I mean, Mr. Francis, never had any of this and was able, with the prayer from the man of God, was able to walk. So this is indeed a miracle. There's no question about it. We thank Jesus for that.
Mr. Patrick Francis and his family come forward to testify of the healing power of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord. Emmanuel. My name is Mr. Patrick Francis. I'm here to testify to the Lord, for the goodness of the Lord in my life. Last year, January, on my way from office home, I had a motorcycle accident that led to the breaking of my tibia and fibula. Since then, I could not walk from POP to POP. They will change and change. From January to June, POP was on my leg. They lose the POP on the 4th June. I decided to come to Synagogue Church of All Nations. My doctor was angry that anything can happen to this bone and it will lead to a broken. If it broke again, they will go on operation. I said it's not my portion. Where my faith is, that is where I'm going. When I came to Synagogue Church of All Nations, they received me with open hand. When I came, when the man of God prayed for me, he asked me to come out of the vehicle. I was scared because it's only me that know what, it's only me know what happened to me. And for me to touch this leg on the floor, I'm scared of it. But to God be the glory, I walk up to the stand. Yeah, I walk to my seat. Since then, I throw away the crutches. And one wonderful thing, and one marvelous thing that God did, I was shocked. My right leg, there was injury there. And that injury refused to go because of the pain. They healed me on Sunday. On Monday, the injury, it closed face. Injury was healed. Ever since then, I have not used crutches anymore. I didn't use any walking stick. I went back to my destination. I went to office. My boss, all my white men, they were shocked that they don't believe it, that I can walk now. But to their surprise, they see that I'm walking. So to God be the glory. I don't pray for anyone to break a bone or even a dislocation because you cannot do anything. You cannot lift anything up because if I'm walking, even to shift the leg, the bone are touching each other and it's painful. So going to toilet is my wife. Bathing me is she. Everything around me, I need somebody to help me. If not, I cannot do anything.
But after the prayer of the anointed man of God, can you tell us the things you can do now the Lord has set you free?
Things I can do now a lot. I'm walking now. I've resumed back to work. I can run and I can jump. I can do everything as every other person can do.
Emmanuel, my name is Elizabeth Patrick. When he was down, he could not walk. He could not go to toilet. He could not bathe himself. I'm the one helping him doing everything. To the glory of God, I'm free from all those things. I thank God.
Filled with the joy of the Lord for the glory of God. As he runs, jumps, and walks, Mr. Patrick Francis proves beyond all doubt that he is healed and Jesus Christ is his healer. Praise the Lord. Special message on my birthday celebration this year, TB Joshua. Next Sunday is my birthday, June 12, 2016. This is the most appropriate time to reach you, my viewers,
my members, and my partners all over the world on how to celebrate my June 12th birthday, which comes next Sunday. In times of joblessness, strikes, hunger, depression, and poor economy, the best place to celebrate a birthday is among the sick, the poor, the disadvantaged, and the jobless. The Bible says, "Come, all ye that are weak, sick, and disadvantaged, and I will give you rest." As for me, the celebrant, there is a special healing, deliverance, and blessing session this coming Saturday. Then on the next day, Sunday, my birthday, we shall use the occasion and the moment to listen to their various testimonies, and together we rejoice with them. This special registration for only the sick people and the oppressed shall take place on this coming Wednesday and Friday, starting from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. on each day. I hereby request all my viewers, members of our synagogue, and our partners to join me in this special prayer for their effective deliverance and healing. God bless you as you join me. On your part, use every blessing God has given you to bless and care for someone who is in need of what you have, including just your mere smile, or tell someone I love you with all your heart.
The time has come.
All of you that believe and connect with me, good morning.
To be connected. To have TV Joshua in your home.
I can see!
Emmanuel TV, now available on DSTV channel 390. Get connected now. To witness more about the ministry of TB Joshua and the Synagogue Church of All Nations, tune in to Emmanuel TV. And wherever you are, get connected. If you are in Africa or parts of Europe, you can find us free to air on the Intelsat 20 KU band Europe Africa beam. If you have any free to air decoder, please refer to our website www.emmanuel.tv for full details on how to tune in. If you are watching from Asia, Australia, Middle East, or parts of Europe, you can find us free to air on the Tycom 5 C-band global beam. If you are watching from North America, including USA, Canada, and Mexico, you can also find us free to air on the Galaxy 19 satellite. Alternatively, you can watch us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, from anywhere in the world on the internet. Just log into our website www.emmanuel.tv or download our official Emmanuel TV mobile app to view us on your mobile device. For more information about the channel, you can send us an email to info@emmanuel.tv. Emmanuel TV, changing lives, changing nations, and changing the world.
Pour voir plus, entendre plus, être témoin de plus du ministère du prophète TB Joshua et de la synagogue église de toutes les nations, connectez-vous sur emmanuel.tv. Et là, vous vous trouvez, soyez connectés. Si vous êtes en Afrique ou en Europe, vous venez gratuitement sur Intelsat 20 KU Band. Dans le rayon d'Afrique et d'Europe, si vous avez un décodeur libre, référez-vous à notre site internet www.emmanuel.tv pour plus de détails sur comment vous connecter. Si vous regardez de l'Asie, l'Australie, Moyen-Orient, Europe, vous pouvez aussi nous trouver gratuitement sur Tycom 5 C-Band sur un rayon global. Si vous nous regardez de l'Amérique du Nord, des États-Unis, le Canada et le Mexique, vous pouvez nous trouver gratuitement sur Galaxy 19 Satellite. Alternativement, vous pouvez nous regarder 24 heures sur 24, 7 jours sur 7, partout dans le monde sur Internet. Connectez-vous sur notre site internet www.emmanuel.tv ou téléchargez notre application mobile officielle sur votre smartphone. Pour plus d'informations concernant la chaîne, vous pouvez nous envoyer un email à info@emmanuel.tv. Emmanuel TV, changez les vies, changez les nations. Changer le monde.
Para ver más, escuchar más, para ser testigo de más del ministerio de TV Joshua y la sinagoga Iglesia de Todas las Naciones, conéctate a Emmanuel TV desde donde quiera que estés. Si estás en África o en alguna parte de Europa, nos puedes sintonizar al aire en el Intelsat 20KU en la frecuencia de señal de Europa África. Si tienes un decodificador para señal abierta, infórmate en nuestra página web www.emmanuel.tv sobre cómo sintonizarnos. Si nos estás viendo desde Asia, Australia, Oriente Medio o alguna parte de Europa, nos puedes sintonizar al aire en ThaiCom 5C en la frecuencia de señal global. Si nos estás viendo desde América del Norte, incluyendo Estados Unidos, Canadá y México, nos puedes sintonizar al aire en el satélite Galaxy 19. Alternativamente, nos puedes ver las 24 horas, los 7 días de la semana, desde cualquier parte del mundo a través del Internet. Simplemente conéctate a nuestra página web www.emmanuel.tv o descarga nuestra aplicación oficial de Emmanuel TV para podernos ver desde tu teléfono móvil. Para recibir más información acerca del canal, nos puedes mandar un correo a info@emmanuel.tv. Emmanuel TV, cambiando vidas, cambiando naciones y cambiando el mundo.
Explore. Look new and easy. Emmanuel TV mobile app. With easy access to all the Synagogue Church of All Nations, TV Joshua and Emmanuel TV social networking sites. The app is simple and easy and is compatible with iPhones, Android devices, iPads, and Android tablets. You can send your prayer requests and watch Emmanuel TV live and pray along with Prophet TV Joshua, or send your testimonies and much, much more. Available for free download at www.emmanuel.tv.
Anywhere you are, distance is not a barrier. Viewers, you are called to battle the spiritual entities which cause crisis in your lives. You and Prophet TV Joshua, together in the name of Jesus, can stop Satan killing, stealing, and destroying your life. Touch the screen right now. Engage with God.
They were all over the world. Ask God to give you enablement, to give you grace, to forgive those who sin against you. Lord Jesus, give me grace. Give me grace. Give me grace. Grace enough. 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 In Jesus Christ's name. We will listen to the voice of God. Whatever demon in your life, I speak to them and I command them to leave you in the name of Jesus. I command them to leave you in the name of Jesus. Let there be light. Let there be light. Let there be light. Every sickness in your life, in your bone, in your tendon, in your kidney, in your liver, in your blood, in your bone, right now I command them to leave in the name of Jesus. Leave my people. You sickness, you disease, you affliction, leave my people. Leave my people. You sickness, you disease, you affliction, leave my people. The name Jesus, every tongue shall confess, every knee shall bow. I say, you demon, you are synonymous to affliction, you are synonymous to sickness. Leave my people. Leave my people. Leave my people. In the name of Jesus, rejoice.
Leave you under the influence of the Holy Spirit and pray to meet you there again. Allow your heart to be deeply engaged with God as you send your testimony.
Somebody needs your testimony to strengthen their faith, to get them out of their desperate setback. When you acknowledge God as your healer, as your redeemer, as your Savior,
will do it again and again. So what is your testimony? Share it with us. Log on to www.emmanuel.tv, then click on Testimonies. Then type in your name, email address, and other details in the spaces provided. If you wish to upload a picture to attach to your testimony, click on the Browse button, select the picture from where you saved it on your computer, and click Open. Next, type in your glorious testimony in the box below, then click Submit. You can also share your testimony by calling our testimony lines. Each time God leads us through a battle, it is in our own interest to testify to His goodness as a way of thanksgiving for not allowing our adversaries to triumph over us. We look forward to hearing your testimony. The best is yet to come.
Jesus addressed his followers. Truly I tell you, anyone who will not receive the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter it. Luke 18:16-17. And the Bible encourages us in Ephesians 5:1, therefore be imitators of God as dear children. Train the child in the way they should go. When they are old, they shall not depart from it. Proverbs 22:6. When you open your heart to God, you begin to get His ideas. Now, get ready to watch the Emmanuel TV kids all over the world in action as they open their hearts to God. Joshua 2. Send in your footage to info@emmanuel.tv. Woohoo!
Emmanuel, Matthew 1:23. Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, meaning the God with us. Jesus Christ still empowers his followers to change the world today. Distance is not a barrier to God's move. Emmanuel TV. God with us.
Sometimes discouraged, but not defeated. Cast down, but not destroyed. Times I don't understand, but I believe it's turning around for me. Hallelujah. Struggles and disappointments, the times I felt so alone.
Worship the King of Kings, for it is turning around for your good. Hallelujah. Oh. Now listen, around for me.
Around for me.
It's turning around, yeah.
Turning around.
Hallelujah. So let's quickly look at the book of Psalm 107, verse 20. He sent forth his word and healed them. He sent forth his word and what? It means his word is quite different from the word you are used to. He said he sent forth his word. It's saying his own word. So this must be word of the Holy Spirit. This must be what? Word of what? Yes. If it's Christ's word, it's word of Holy Spirit. And before you can make use of his word, your soul must be guided towards it. It means your spirit must act upon the word of faith. That is, after you have planted the seed, imperishable seed, that is the word of God, you believe it is growing. You what? You believe it is growing before you see it what? Before you see it grow. Before the word is planted, it must be known, received, and steadfastly trusted. To plant the word, for the word to dominate our heart. And for the word to dominate your heart, the word must be known, received, and trusted. This is faith, which is the evidence of things not seen. In Christ Jesus, we have perfect evidence for faith. Tell your neighbor, you can get rid of your doubt. I can hear you. By the word of the Holy Spirit. The word is not planted until it is known, received, and trusted. They say it is settled forever, O Lord. It is not settled until it is what? Known, received, and trusted. It is not settled. You can never believe in Christ Jesus until the word is known and received and trusted. I mean, it must be planted, watered, and steadfastly trusted. By continuing hearing the word, you grow.
Good morning, viewers around the world. I'm here today with a special message from Prophet T.B. Joshua about the secrets behind his consistent good health over the years, despite the demands of ministry. You see, blessing without good health is a crisis because you cannot enjoy it. As 1 Thessalonians 5 verses 22 to 23 says, we are a spirit, we have a soul, and we live in a body. This same body can get sick, can get tired, and needs attention. In other words, the natural and the spiritual must function together. For the natural to function, you must take care of your body. So the question is, well, how should we? How should we care for our body? Well, brethren, listen to this revelation from God to Prophet T.B. Joshua. Water therapy. Prophet T.B. Joshua explained that before his morning prayer, or immediately after it, we're talking of 4 a.m., 5 a.m., 6 a.m. in the morning, he will take a 150 centiliters bottle of water. That's 1.5 liters. He'll pour it into a glass and in under 2 to 3 minutes, make sure he finishes the entire bottle. Now, the Prophet explained, I'm not drinking it because I'm thirsty. I'm drinking it for a purpose, to flush my system. Now, after taking this large bottle, you should then take another smaller bottle, 75 centiliters or 0.75 liters, between 2 to 3 p.m. in the afternoon, and then another one again around 5 to 6 p.m. in the evening. And one thing you have to understand, this water therapy should replace all sugary drinks if you want to enjoy a good and a healthy life. The question you may be asking is, well, which water should I use? Well, you can purchase, you know, bottled water, or you can just use normal, ordinary water from the tap. But one thing is clear, the water should be room temperature, normal water, not icy or cold water. After taking this water early in the morning, please note that you may urinate several times over the course of that morning, and you'll see that your urine is pure and clear. So by the time you notice your urine becoming a little bit yellowish early in the afternoon, it's a sign that you need to go and take another bottle of water. And brethren, the benefits of this habit, this water therapy, are so many, although it will be difficult to cultivate at the beginning. Firstly, it will moderate your eating habits. It will help fight sickness and disease in your system. It will also help you in losing weight. It will foster the growth of your hair, your nails. It will purify your skin. Truly, God has given us everything we need to live a good and healthy life. So brethren, this water therapy is the key to capture your health. And as you follow this instruction in righteousness from our Father in the Lord, Prophet T.B. Joshua, we look forward to hearing your wonderful testimonies in Jesus' name. Once again, good morning. Thank you, Jesus.
Buenos días, televidentes de todo el mundo. Hoy estoy aquí con un mensaje especial del profeta T.B. Joshua sobre el secreto detrás de su constante buena salud a través de todos los años, a pesar de los requerimientos de su ministerio. La bendición sin buena salud es una crisis porque no la puedes disfrutar. Como dice en 1 Tesalonicenses 5, 22 al 23, nosotros somos un espíritu, tenemos un alma y vivimos en el cuerpo. El mismo cuerpo puede enfermarse, cansarse y requiere atención. Lo natural y lo espiritual deben trabajar en conjunto para que lo natural funcione. Debes cuidar de tu cuerpo. Entonces, ¿cómo deberíamos cuidar nuestro cuerpo? Bueno, así que escuchemos esta revelación de Dios para el profeta T.B. Joshua, la terapia del agua. Explicó que antes o inmediatamente después de su oración en la mañana, refiriéndose a las 4, 5 o 6 de la mañana, toma una botella de agua de 1.5 litros y la sirve dentro de un vaso y dentro de 2 o 3 minutos se asegura de terminarla. Según él, el secreto detrás de esto no es beber agua cuando tiene sed, como es de costumbre. Él dijo, no la tomo porque tenga sed, yo la tomo por un propósito, para limpiar mi sistema. Después de esta botella grande, deberías tomar una botella pequeña de 750 mililitros entre las 2 o 3 de la tarde y una más alrededor de las 5 o 6 de la tarde. Esta terapia del agua debería reemplazar todas las bebidas azucaradas si quieres tener una buena vida. La pregunta que tal vez te haces, ¿qué tipo de aguas deberías tomar? Puedes comprar agua embotellada o simplemente puedes tomar agua normal del grifo. Pero una cosa es clara, el agua debe estar a temperatura ambiente, no fría ni helada. Después de tomar el agua muy temprano en la mañana, fíjate que puedes orinar varias veces y te darás cuenta que tu orina es pura y clara. Cuando notes que tu orina se torna más amarilla, es una señal que deberías tomar otra botella de agua. Los beneficios de este hábito son múltiples, a pesar de la dificultad de cultivarlo al principio. Primeramente, regulará los hábitos alimenticios, combatirá la enfermedad en tu sistema, ayudará a perder peso, promoverá el crecimiento del cabello y uñas y también purificará la piel. Verdaderamente, Dios nos ha dado todo lo que necesitamos para vivir una buena vida. Hermanos, esta terapia del agua es la clave para capturar tu salud para la gloria de Dios. Mientras siguen esta instrucción en justicia, esperamos escuchar los maravillosos testimonios en el nombre de Jesús. Buenos días.
Bonjour téléspectateurs du monde entier. Je suis ici avec un message spécial du prophète Tibi Joshua. Message donné le dimanche 4 janvier 2015, révélant à la congrégation de la synagogue Église de toutes les nations le secret derrière sa bonne santé. Il n'a jamais été absent d'une réunion de dimanche, ni voyagé à l'étranger pour un traitement médical à cause de ce secret. Une bénédiction sans une bonne santé est une crise parce que vous ne pourrez pas en savourer le plaisir. 1 Thessaloniciens 5, versets 22 à 23 dit que nous sommes un esprit, nous avons une âme et nous vivons dans un corps. Le même corps peut être fatigué et avoir besoin d'attention. Parce que le naturel et le spirituel doivent fonctionner ensemble, pour bien vivre dans le naturel, vous devez prendre soin de votre corps. Comment donc prendre soin de son corps? Écoutez donc cette révélation du prophète Tibi Joshua concernant sa vie, la thérapie de l'eau. Il dit qu'avant ma prière du matin ou immédiatement après ma prière du matin, je parle de 4h, 5h ou 6h du matin, je bois cette bouteille d'eau qui est une bouteille de 150 centilitres, c'est-à-dire 1,5 litre. Je verse successivement le contenu dans un verre et en moins de 2 à 3 minutes, je m'assure de boire tout le contenu de la bouteille d'eau. Je répète, je finis la bouteille entière en moins de 2 ou 3 minutes. C'est un peu difficile au début, mais avec le temps, on s'y habitue. Les gens boivent parce qu'ils ont soif. Je ne bois pas, dit-il, parce que j'ai soif. Je bois pour un but, pour purger mon système. Après cette grande bouteille, vous devez prendre maintenant une bouteille de 75 centilitres entre 14h et 15h et boire encore une nouvelle bouteille de 75 centilitres autour de 17h et 18h. Cette eau remplace toutes les boissons sucrées. Elle ne doit pas être glacée ni froide, que l'eau soit à la température ambiante, c'est-à-dire de l'eau ordinaire. Ce que je vous demande de faire, dit le prophète, est ordinaire. Abandonnez les glaçons, dites au revoir à la glace. Pour ceux qui n'ont pas les moyens d'acheter des bouteilles d'eau quotidiennement, prenez juste de l'eau du robinet et remplissez la bouteille tout simplement. Mais dit-il, il y a une différence entre avoir soif et boire. Ce n'est pas une question d'avoir soif et de prendre de l'eau. C'est au moment où vous ne voulez pas boire que vous devriez vous forcer à boire. Et vous noterez qu'après avoir pris cette bouteille d'eau le matin, que vos urines sont de couleur claire et pure. Mais quand elle devient jaune, cela montre que vous avez besoin de plus d'eau. Il y a beaucoup de choses qui bloquent votre système, vos reins, votre foie, autres organes. Mais cela aussi réduira votre appétit à manger, cela aussi purifiera votre peau, combattra les maladies dans votre système et améliorera la croissance de vos cheveux. La thérapie par l'eau est très importante pour vous. Dieu nous a donné tout ce qu'il faut pour mener une bonne vie, mais nous sommes ignorants. Ceci est une question de discipline. La thérapie par l'eau est la clé pour capturer votre santé. Enseignez cela à vos enfants. Et alors que vous suivez cette instruction dans la justice, nous attendons votre témoignage. Bonjour à votre santé. Encore une fois, bonjour à votre santé.
Special message on my birthday celebration this year, TB Joshua. Next Sunday is my birthday, June 12, 2016. This is the most appropriate time to reach you, my viewers, my members, and my partners all over the world on how to celebrate my June 12th birthday, which comes next Sunday. In times of joblessness, strikes, hunger, depression, and poor economy, the best place to celebrate a birthday is among the sick, the poor, the disadvantaged, and the jobless. The Bible says, "Come, all ye that are weak, sick, and disadvantaged, and I will give you rest. As for me, the celebrant, there is a special healing, deliverance, and blessing session this coming Saturday. Then on the next day, Sunday, my birthday, we shall use the occasion and the moment to listen to their various testimonies, and together we rejoice with them. This special registration for only the sick people and the oppressed shall take place on this coming Wednesday and Friday, starting from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. on each day. I hereby request all my viewers, members of our synagogue, and our partners to join me in this special prayer for their effective deliverance and healing. God bless you as you join me. On your part, use every blessing God has given you to bless and care for someone who is in need of what you have, including just your mere smile, or tell someone I love you with all your heart.
If you would like to visit the Synagogue Church of the Nations, log on to our website www.goan.org. Go to the Visit Us page. And for those from within Nigeria, you can call the three visit lines that appear on the website. For those from outside Nigeria, there are some frequently asked questions that will assist you in your visit procedure. Remember, it is essential that anyone from outside Nigeria should fill in the questionnaire. Please remember to answer every question that is asked. And after you have filled in the questionnaire, remember to click Send. Please note, you must wait to receive an invitation or confirmation of your visit from us before making any traveling arrangements or flight bookings. All communication with the Synagogue Church of All Nations should be through the following email address, info@goan.org. We look forward to hearing from you. Emmanuel, God with us.
Mi nombre es el pastor Rubén Funes y vengo del Ministerio Cristiano Euroharvest en Madrid, en Alcorcón, en España, claro. Pues la verdad que ha sido una experiencia sobrenatural. La manifestación del poder de Dios está en todo este lugar, el Shekinah, la gloria de Dios invadiendo este lugar. Hemos visto manifestaciones de todo tipo, liberaciones, y cómo el poder de Dios que operaba en los primeros discípulos, en los apóstoles y en la iglesia de Cristo está aquí operando de una forma hermosa, linda, completa, y a pesar que llevamos 12 horas de servicio, de adoración y de liberación, de salvación, estamos para seguir otras cuantas más, porque está la fuerza, el renuevo de Dios. Pues el mensaje que yo puedo transmitirles en este momento es que apoyen esta obra de Dios, que sean partners, que sean colaboradores de este ministerio, porque este ministerio está en expansión. No solamente es las imágenes que a veces conocemos de obra social, ONG, ayuda al necesitado, sino la obra espiritual, el centro internacional que este ministerio está trayendo gente de toda nación y visite la SCOAN, la sinagoga de toda la iglesia de todas las naciones. Es un lugar internacional donde el poder de Dios se mueve sin distinción de raza, idioma ni lugar donde usted venga. Uno de los propósitos que me trajeron aquí, a este lugar, fue el ser atraído por la gloria de Dios. Donde está la gloria de Dios, donde está la manifestación del poder de Dios, hay como un imán que atrae a los que estamos hambrientos, sedientos, que queremos un rompimiento, que queremos un progreso en nuestra vida ministerial. Y ese fue mi caso. Mi caso personal fue un rompimiento en mi vida general, sobre todo ministerial, porque yo quiero lo que se mueve aquí, yo lo quiero en España, en Europa, y quiero ser un canal, si el Espíritu de Dios lo desea, para poder transmitir y llevar lo que aquí hay. Agradecido de todo corazón al profeta TV Joshua, gracias de todo corazón, y vamos a compartir lo que hemos recibido acá con el resto de España. Y gracias de todo corazón, Emmanuel TV, sinagoga, iglesia de todas las naciones. Dios le bendiga. Gracias.